Hello, Elia.
Hi, Sophie.
You work as a project officer at the Interreg Baltic Sea Region program. In this tutorial, I will ask you a few questions about the program objective on energy transition. Please tell me, what was the main reason to include energy transition as one of the program objectives and what does it cover?
Through this program objective, we would like to support the transition towards a low-carbon society in the Baltic Sea region. This means that our program covers actions not only for the reduction of greenhouse gas emissions, but also for a more intensive use of renewable energy sources. We also aim to apply climate-neutral energy solutions and to improve energy efficiency.
Do you mean applying certain measures in the industrial sector?
Yes, but not only. We would like to support public authorities in updating policies as well as integrating energy efficiency measures in the public sector. And we plan to encourage citizens to use energy solutions in their houses. This way, we would like to address energy transition in a more comprehensive way.
Can you think of a potential project that could fit here?
An example could be a project developing a system for producing, using and accumulating renewable energy and piloting some elements of the system. This could be piloted in public buildings like schools or university canteens, for example. Potential applicants can design and implement this kind of project in cooperation with public authorities responsible for environmental protection and energy, infrastructure and service providers, as well as enterprises.
What kind of target groups are relevant under this program objective?
First of all, we target public authorities at local, regional and national levels. Those could be municipalities, regional councils, ministries, as well as governmental agencies. They all have an important role in setting a strategic direction to advance the energy transition towards low-carbon energy systems. When it comes to the introduction of energy solutions for climate neutrality, other target groups should also be addressed, such as sectoral agencies, business support organizations, infrastructure and service providers, as well as enterprises. And let's not forget about NGOs and associations of citizens.
What about higher education and research organizations? Do they also have a role to play?
Yes, they could support the other target groups we just talked about with their expertise and competences for developing, for example, efficient energy solutions.
You mentioned public authorities. What challenges do they face and need to address in cooperation with other organizations?
Public authorities are key enablers for decarbonizing energy systems through developing and implementing policies and regulations. However, public authorities sometimes lack knowledge how to update existing energy plans in order to make them climate neutral. They lack competences to support industries and citizens in applying energy-efficient solutions that are already on the market. To address this, they need expertise and competences from different sectors.
And which challenges do local communities or citizens face when it comes to energy? Is heat loss in buildings one of those challenges?
They often lack knowledge on up-to-date technologies that can be applied to save energy in buildings. Heat loss in building is a big problem indeed. Consider more than half of the building stock in the BSR is still energy inefficient because heating systems consume a lot of energy. But heat loss concerns not only buildings. A large amount of heat is also lost in industrial processes. Apart from the relevant knowledge, both communities and industries would need financial support to pilot energy-saving measures. They also need information about different financial tools and support schemes to implement those measures at a wider scale.
Can you give us an example of an action to improve energy efficiency?
Yes, it can be a solution to lower temperature in district heating systems. Partners can develop this solution while exchanging on good practices among municipalities, which are successful in optimizing the existing district heating systems.
So I understand that the projects can develop specific energy measures at the local and regional levels, but joint work on solutions is key here, right? Since we know that transnational cooperation is what characterizes the Interreg Baltic Sea Region programme, could you give any other examples of actions which could be implemented in a transnational way?
Sure, transnational cooperation is a must for all projects. An action could be, for instance, to test mechanisms to coordinate the development of renewable energy projects across borders in different countries. Another example of a project could be where partners adapt policies and regulations and then coordinate plans and their application across borders. Of course, local and regional spatial planning would need to be considered in this coordination exercise.
I guess that the exchange of knowledge and expertise would be necessary to implement such actions, right?
You pointed out a crucial aspect. To coordinate across borders, meaning across different systems, project partners would need to share their experience, knowledge, and expertise. We expect that partners will learn from each other and therefore increase their capacities to move towards low-carbon energy systems with enhanced renewable energy use and increased energy efficiency.
Could you give an example of a project which already dealt with energy efficiency?
Yes, we had a project which demonstrated that advanced power electronics are technically feasible, reliable and cost-efficient in test applications of electric car engines, wind energy production, as well as smart buildings. The project compiled a roadmap to help industries start using these energy-saving technologies. In addition, this project reached out to hundreds of companies to help them adjust their product development and consider advanced power electronics in their business models.
Coming back to public authorities that you refer to as a key target group, why would they participate in projects on energy transition? Could you give an example?
Sure. For example, energy and spatial planning authorities may come together in a project to improve planning of new renewable energy objects in their countries. They can develop guidelines on spatial planning or action plans on production of renewable energy and its storage. In this process, other organizations should be involved. These could be authorities responsible for issuing permits, energy agencies, experts from research organizations. When developing action plans, municipalities should consider local conditions and production sites for available types of energy, for example, wind, solar, biomass energy.
From what you say, it is important to explore local renewable energy sources. This will have an impact on local communities. How can citizens be involved in energy planning processes?
Representatives of local communities need to be involved in all phases of energy transition, starting from planning. Projects should find a way to better involve citizens and also motivate them to have an active role in the energy transition. For example, in one of our projects, partners set up renewable energy cooperative partnerships that initiated community energy projects. Those partnerships included different actors, ranging from citizens' associations to decision makers. Together, they planned, discussed, and decided on the production of sustainable renewable energy.
How is it possible to check if energy solutions developed by a project are effective?
Project partners can pilot such solutions in the different countries that are part of the project. They can test, for example, energy efficiency technologies which best fit their needs. Or they can test how to produce renewable energy from combined sources at a small scale in their cities.
This brings us to the end of our tutorial on energy transition. Thanks a lot for your explanations, Elea.